coming from class 7 students. Hopefully you all will be fine, safe and sound. Okay, maybe you all of know we have started exercise of chapter number 4, Wellness and Mental Wellness in our last lecture. Okay, and we have done takeout page number 57 of your book. We have done MCQs question number 1 and 2 false question number 2 in our books. Okay, today we will start our exercise from page number 58. So please take out page number 58 of chapter number 4. So question number 3 is given. You can also see on the screen question number 3. A student has a magnetic compass. He also has three metal bar pointing to the same. One is copper, one is unmagnetized or iron, and other is a permanent magnet. Describe how he can find out which bar is the magnet. Okay, so first understand the question. A student has a magnetic compass. He also has three metal bars. He has three different metal bars. They need to look the same. And these three bars are looking same. But inside the plane, one bar is made of copper. One is unmagnetized iron and the other is a permanent magnet. So describes how we can find out which bar is the magnet. So now the important question is that how a person can find that which bar is the magnet. So we can find. I will discuss the answer with you. Okay. So look at your book, the student places the compass close to all three metal bars. So what will be the working of student? He will place these three bars, okay, and he will place the compass close to all three metal bars. The copper bar and the iron bar will cause no response from the compass needle when placed alongside the permanent magnet. The compass needle will align itself according to the of the magnet. Answer is very simple. Okay, how a person can find which is a magnet bar? So when he will take compass near to these three bars, so when it will take compass near to copper bar and the metal bar, definitely they are not magnet. Okay, they are not magnetized. So what will be happen? They will not give any response. But when he will take the compass near to the permanent magnet, definitely permanent magnet is a magnet which holds the properties of all magnetic forces. So when a wire took near to when a compass take near to the permanent magnet, so it will arrange itself, remains will be aligned in itself, and because of that the north and south pole will be shown. So the magnet bar, which is a permanent magnet, it will show the properties of magnetic force or magnetism. I hope you understand the question. Next is question number 4. The diagram shows, you can also see the diagram on the screen. The diagram shows a piece of iron held by a wire attached to a magnet. So, in this diagram, you can see a piece of iron which is near to the magnet. So, what will be happen? Question number 1. Arc on the iron where the induced and the north and south poles are. Arc on the iron where the induced north and south poles are. So you can also see on the screen it is a bar magnet. Okay. So north and south poles are showing on it. And question number 2, question number 1 and question number 3, their answers are same. So first I will discuss the question number 1 and question number. Now we will go to question number 2. One theory of magnetism is the idea that iron contains tiny molecular magnets which can line up in magnetic fields. We also have discussed this theory in the chapter. Okay. What is the theory? That the idea that iron contains tiny molecular magnets which can line up in magnetic fields. Yes, we all know that every piece of iron has molecular magnets inside it. So when we take a magnet near to them, they come into line, they are aligned with the magnet. And you also have seen the diagram where the mains in your book that the mains in an unmagnetized iron, they are in the jumble of gold. But when we put them near to the magnet, so because of that, these all are and you can also see this figure on page number in question number 6. A diagram is given in which you can see it's a graph of magnet. Okay, in this figure, you can see that the domains are not in a line. Okay, so when you take this piece given in your book, the when you take the magnet near to an iron, so tiny molecular magnets which can line up in the magnetic. So, we will use this theory to explain how an unmagnetized. So, use this theory and explain how an unmagnetized iron bar is attracted to a magnet. How an unmagnetized iron bar is attracted to a magnet.
Very good.
So, I will discuss the answer. When a magnet is placed near an unmagnetized iron bar, the molecular magnets in the bar line up in groups to form domains. These domains are sensitive to magnetic field. So, as a result, the iron bar becomes magnetized. Answer is simple. When a magnet is placed near an unmagnetized iron bar, the molecular magnets the bar line up in groups to form domains. These domains are sensitive to magnetic field. So, as a result, the iron bar is magnetized. In simple words, we can say if we have an unmagnetized bar and we have a permanent magnet near an unmagnetized bar, so the domains which are present inside, of course, they will be a jungle form. But due to magnetic force, due to magnetism, they will come into a line. They will be come into a straight line. So this thing shows that as a result, an iron bar is magnetized. We can take an iron bar into a magnetized bar. I want to understand it. Come to question number 5. Question number 5, part 1. Describe briefly two ways of turning an unmagnetized steel rod into a permanent magnet. I will have to discuss the method.
How can it
transfer? How can we make a steel rod into a permanent magnet? How can we change steel rod into a permanent magnet? So keep in your mind, a steel rod into a permanent magnet. In your mind, we also discussed this thing in a book that iron is called a soft magnetic material. Steel is called a hard magnet. So now how can we unmagnetize steel rod? Definitely steel rod or steel magnet is a permanent magnet. So it is difficult to change the into unmagnetized. But there are different methods in which we will discuss to number one. By soaking the steel rod with one pole of a magnet. First method is that by soaking the steel rod. Okay, by soaking the steel rod with one pole of a magnet, if we soak is one end of in and again, so because of that, and the second method is that by placing a piece of steel inside the coil of wire, passing an electric current through the coil, what will be happens? Electric poles will be introduced in the steel. The second method is that if you want to make a magnetized So he will put another piece of steel inside the pilot pipe and passing an electric current to the coil. What will be happen? Magnetic force will be introduced in the steel. So because of that, our permanent magnet can become magnetized. These are the two methods through which we can unmagnetize steel rod into a permanent magnet. These are the two goals. Because of that, we can convert unmagnetized steel rod into a permanent magnet. Now, question number two: describe different ways of demagnetizing the steel rod which has become magnetized. Second question is the first question. First question was that okay, how can we magnetize a steel rod? In which we discussed two methods. Number one, by strengthening the steel rod on both of a magnet. Second, we discussed by placing a piece of steel inside a coil of wire and passing an electric current through the coil. Which electric force we use in the steel? The steel rod will convert into a permanent magnet. Now we have to discuss how can we unmagnetize the steel rod. So there are two methods. First is by heating. If you want to convert a steel rod into unmagnetized steel, first we will put the water. In hot water, we put the magnet inside it. Okay, and after taking out from hot water, we immediately put into cold water. Then the magnet will go from heating procedure to cold procedure. So because of that, it will be unmagnetized. So here you can write the method. Number one is by heating. Because of that, you can unmagnetize the item. By heating a magnet with a hammer or dropping it on a hard floor. The second method is that by heating a magnet with a hammer. If we hit the magnet by a hammer again and again hardly, and dropping it on a hard floor, we drop it on a hard floor. What will be happen? Because of that, it will be unmagnetized. I hope you understand these two methods. In first part, we have discussed methods in which we can magnetize the steel rod. In question number 5, part 2, we have discussed that how can we unmagnetize the item. Come to our question number 6. The diagram shows the jumper arm to means being a magnetized. You can also see the figure on your book. This is the figure and the figure of bar magnet. And you can see there are different arrows. Between these arrows are called bullets. They are jumper arrows. They are not in a line. They are not organized inside the bar magnet. So now we will see. Question number 1 is that draw a diagram showing what happens when the magnet is held nearby. And question number 3, label the poles on the new magnet. Definitely on the right side, you will write north pole, and on the left side, you will write the south pole. This is the answer of the question number 1, draw a diagram. So you will draw this diagram again. Okay, and the arrows which are in the jumper form, you will take them in a line. So these arrows are showing the domains inside the magnet. When we draw this diagram again, so in that diagram, these all arrows are in a domain. They all should be in a line. Okay. So question number 1 and question number 3. In both questions, you have to draw the diagram. In question number 3, label the poles of the new magnet. You can see on the right hand, on the right side of your hand, you have to write the rod, and at the left side, you have to write the. These are the two modes. Rod is always right side, and sound is always left side. And now we will discuss the question. Question number six. What name is given to this process? What name is given to this process? Okay, we can see what is this process. We also discussed in the book. This process is called induced mechanism. Question number two answer is there. What is this process? This process is called induced mechanism. So please write on your book. This process is called induced mechanism. Now we can discuss question number four. This is question number six, part four. What happens to the domains where the magnet is taken away? Explain your answer. This thing we have discussed when we take magnet here to our unmagnetized iron, the domains which are not in the arranged form will come in line and they will be inside the R magnet. But here the question we are asking is these domains. Are not. What happens to the domains when the magnet is taken away? If the magnet is taken away, if we take this magnet far away, the far away, so what will happen with the what will be happen with the domain for us? I will discuss the answer of question number six. When the magnet is taken away, the iron piece. When the magnet is taken away from the iron piece, the iron retains its induced magnetism, although this is weak. Answer is very simple. When the iron is taken away, the magnet bar also keeps the properties of induced magnetism inside. So I am discussing the answer again. Part 4. When the magnet is taken away from the iron piece, the iron retains its hold. So the iron retains induced magnetism, although this is weak. Induced magnetism, although this is weak. I want to understand the question. Now we can move to the question number 7. What is a solenoid? This definition we have discussed in the book, and I also have found that this is very important. The answer is that a long, tightly wound wire is called a solenoid. A long, tightly wound wire is called a long, tightly wound wire is called a first part, what is a solenoid? A long, tightly wound coil is called a solenoid. Okay, so underline the answer. Write the answer. And this answer is also given in your short questions. Now come to question number 7, part 2. Write the magnetic field produced by a solenoid. Write the magnetic produced by a solenoid. So the answer will be the magnetic field looks like that of a car magnet. So the magnetic field looks like that of a car magnet. Now the solenoid is formed. We also see the picture in the book. If we take a piece of then we make more loops. Loops around the steel bar. When we pass electricity, what will be happen due to electricity? This steel rod will convert into a permanent magnet. So, a tightly wound wire. The loops are not tightly wound wire around the steel magnet is called a solenoid. In this question, they are asking.
will be if the magnetic but may be happen solenoid is formed and each type of magnetic field will be produced. So answer is simple. Definitely magnetic field the solenoid is so definitely a magnetic field which is produced around the car should be like a
which is normal, but in the second diagram, when you take
near to the magnet bar. So we open there the leads which is open. Now, what is the question? Design an alarm system. Use the switch which will sound an alarm when our door is open. Okay? You have to see this figure and you have to use this idea. And you have to make a, this is actually, this is a project. You have to make an alarm system, which will sound, and that alarm will produce sound when our door is open. Okay? And we open our door. Do not forget to include a power supply battery. The key switch, magnet, bell or siren. In how your alarm works. Actually, this is a project. I think you have to name this project actually. And the project is there that you have to make up a alarm system and always when we at night we always use alarm clocks. But in the morning, the time which we have set at the time we wake up. So like that to make an alarm system. And this alarm system should be on the door, but this is not necessary. You can also make this project barcode or a sheet, okay? And you have to connect the wire. And the things which are required for this project are the power supply means that you switch to be a bell or siren. Now you have to tell the procedure. How can you make this alarm? You have to make this project and to also write the explanation. I also discuss the procedure with you. Okay? The circuit can be placed on the frame of a door with a magnet. Definitely, can you take all these things to put all these things on your door with the magnet fixed to the door? You have to put when the door is closed, the lead switch is open because of the magnetic field produced by the magnet. This thing you also have seen in your question number 8 about diagram. The lead switch is always closed, but when you create a magnet near to the lead switch, so what will be happen? It will be when you put a magnet and then you put this system along with lead switch, so when you close the door, what will be happen? So the lead switch is open. So when the door is closed, the lead switch is open because of the magnetic field produced by the magnet. As soon as the door is open, the magnet will cause the lead switch to close and complete the circuit. So the alarm will be triggered. That's why the alarm will be triggered. So this is a very simple procedure. Okay? So you have to keep it in your mind. I am telling you this procedure. You have to insert it carefully. The circuit can be placed on a door with a magnet fixed to the door. Okay? When the door is closed, the lead switch is open. Because of the magnetic field produced by the magnet. As soon as the door is open, the magnet will cause the lead switch to close and complete the circuit. The alarm will be. I hope to understand the all questions of exercise. The next one is I have for investigation. This is a project we will discuss later on. Now the work for today class is that you have to do these questions in your I will also share the answers on the screen in a group. So you have to attend from question number 3 to question number 8. So exercise. I also have discussed long question of chapter number 3 with you in the last lecture. Now we have started chapter number 4, okay, and to have the question number 3. Now question number 3 to 8. Answers in short form. I will also share the answers with you. I already have shared it to the group. Okay. And welcome for chapter number 4 is there. Inshallah, we will discuss your questions of 4 and your work in our next lecture. We have a lecture, class 4, class 7. Now, we will discuss the work of nature by tomorrow. So, in this class, hold your workbooks with you and also hold pencils with you. Thank you and keep your work with you. Inshallah, I will first, we have discussed about the traditional magnet, the vertical magnet. Before understanding the magnet, we have discussed the magnetism of force. What is a force? It is a mysterious force. Among the magnets, all magnets have two poles now. And how many? There are two types of magnets. One is called the Faraday magnet, and the other is permanent magnet. The Faraday magnet holds the magnetic property for a short time, and permanent magnets hold the properties of magnetism for a long time. After that, we have discussed about attraction and there are forces of magnets, they move because of the force of attraction. But if we bring near to the same force of magnet near to each other, so what will be happen? They will be different. After that, we have magnetic field. How can we produce the magnet? How can we produce the magnetic field? So I have given to make a compass plane for electric wire. So a magnetic field will be produced. And this all a magnetic field makes circles. And these all circles have. After that, we have discussed about the magnetism. We have discussed that the upper waves, and we discussed that if we can magnetize iron, the waves we should have. But when we put magnet, so because of that, they will come into a line and make the waves. Then we turn the topic using the magnetization of iron. By shooting and giving up. And then we discussed the magnet magnet and okay, and then we also discussed the use of hope you understand the lecture. Now your chapter number 4. Inshallah, we discuss hope in long question by tomorrow in that.